I should have fucking known. I should have fucking known. I joined the lobby of a dude, this one, of a dude called fucking Dr. Doomsday. I should have known he'd be using, he uses Dante Doom Virgil. Shoutouts to that guy. So anyway, have you ever been so what is that flag? What is that? I don't know what that flag is, but I don't want people to know. Fun! I'm a bigot. Have you ever been so frustrated at another game you decided to go play Marvel because it would be less agonizing? That's where I'm at right now. Shoutouts to Dark Souls 2. Oh, that Vip, he's a known player, isn't he? Who am I muting the hell out of? How do I mute you? Start. You? Thank God for that. Aww, that's sad. That Vip isn't actually playing. So anyway. Oh, we've gotten rid of that bullshit. What was I gonna talk? Why are these people? Why do people use microphones and whatever. So in Dark Souls 2, I got to the point where in Scholar of the First Sin, in the PS4 version, you don't start out with access immediately to the DLC areas. You need to go and find items out there in the world. They're not particularly difficult to find, but they require you to get far enough in the game to actually get to them. So the item that blocks off access to, like, the winter frozen area place that houses the Bone Fist, you have to get through Drongleic Castle first. So that's what I did. I finished Drongleic Castle. I got to the very start of Shrine of Amana, and I went back to the Shrine of Winter to go try out that DLC area. And that area whooped my ass. I have been getting beaten black and blue. Just to describe this, I have used more life gems and human effigies in that entire area. Throughout that area, human effigies, for those of you that may not know much about Dark Souls 2, whenever you die, you lose a small portion of your health bar, and it will continue to stack every time you die. It'll go down a little bit further until finally you're at 50% health, and that's called a hollowing process. When you use the human effigy, it reverses that process and gives you back 100% health. So obviously, I don't use it each time I die, but I use it every, like, I guess 3 deaths or so. Very rarely had to use them throughout the main game, not to try and talk about, like, oh, I'm godlike, but it's like, you know, I know what to expect, and I'm pretty good at the series now that I'm not, like, really surprised by anything anymore. So anyway, I have used more human effigies in that area than anywhere else in the game so far, combined. Not just like, oh, I've used more here than this area. Combined, the entire rest of the game, I used less human effigies and less life gems than I have so far in this current area. It is bodying me. It's because I'm trying to walk through like a dumbass, like I'm Iron Fist, basically. Acting like I'm all bad and shit against people with these giant-ass swords, spells, and spears. And it is not fucking working for me. Anywho's. I came to play Marvel instead of dealing with it, because I didn't... I mean, the most hilarious part, a large part of those deaths, like, not to try and act like I didn't die a shit ton. Yo, shoutouts to this guy almost doing a combo in what looks to be quite possibly one of the worst connections I have ever seen on Xbox Live. Like, this is bad PS3 style connection right now. Not just bad Xbox, this is bad PS3 style. Poor bastard, now he's getting hulked. Oh, fucked it up. What would Iron Fist? I guess whiff punishing good. God damn. He should have just gone into that. Yeah. What can... Oh, no, you should have DHC'd. Oh, he could have. I bet he tried and lag ate it. But yeah, he could have DHC'd into Wesker's counter. I wonder, though, if he could have gone... I mean, it would have been totally fucking worth it if he could have DHC'd from Hulk to Dante's... whatever the fuck that shit's called. Devil something or other. Devil form, whatever. But it's not like this dude... Like, look at this. It's not like this dude's gonna be heavily punishing that if he was capable of DHCing rather than hitting the counter. This poor bastard. This poor bastard just trying to play some fair fucking Marvel, and he's dealing with online Hulk and teleporting Dante. This poor bastard. He needs to just fucking beam the hell out of Strange when he sees. I cannot believe he blocked that. But yeah, so anyway, so I thought in that area, I thought I had explored it well. Don't ask me why, because it wasn't like I missed something obscure. It was very fucking... Oh, you know what it actually was? You know what it was? It's because I went... There's this part of the stage... Oh, damn it, now Ryu's dead. Oh, this bastard with the terrible fucking microphone and the terrible connection is gonna take it. Well, he does have online X-Factor Wesker. Oh, please kill Hulk. He could've... Yeah, he's gonna eat all of that. That sucks. Well, he's dead. That sucks. This poor bastard just trying to play the game. And now this dude popping off. Like winning with Hulk Dante in terrible lag. Is anything worth fucking popping off over? I hate you. You suck. But anyway, so I thought... Oh my god. I froze my water and apparently I put a little too much ice in it. It kind of exploded out the top a little bit. It missed my stick. Oh god, it's still coming. It's still coming. It's like Yellowstone National Park is finally popping off. Someone save me. Oh Jesus, that is actually quite a bit of liquid. So now the left side of my shorts now currently looks like I have taken a dip in the ocean. Let me go ahead and fix it. I'll be right back. We'll finish this story in a second. I need to make myself suitable for company right here. God damn. Alright, there we go. I'm more or less dry-ish. So anyway, so I thought I had fully explored this area. I thought I was good. I didn't have any further to go. And, God, this dude just mashing the hell out of Hulk. And so in doing so, oh my god. So I thought, okay, now I need to go through this fog door that's at the very start of the area to continue on with, you know, whatever's going on here. Well, what is through that fog door... is a completely fucking... What did you do? Why would you press buttons in this? Is a completely invisible boss. This giant-ass cat that does, you know, like, half-screen lunge attacks and just stuff that... Good goddamn luck fighting him when he's invisible, especially when you've never participated in this boss battle before. I got blown the fuck up. But like I said, I was assuming the entire time... I've explored this area. I don't have any further to go. I've done everything I can do. Well, I hadn't, but suffice to say, I got blown the fuck up by this boss numerous times. I was raging the fuck out, so finally I was like, you know what, I must be missing something. I have to be missing something. I'm either missing something in the area I'm supposed to be doing, alternatively, I am missing something in, oh, this dude uses X-Factor, yeah, you fuck. Or I missed something in the level, so I went back out and I re-explored, and sure enough, here's this giant-ass doorway in the opposite direction of where I originally went. Impossible to miss, but I forgot about it or missed it or whatever, and so all of that pain and frustration was like, well, all of that was unnecessary and I'm a big fat dummy. But then I continued along in that direction and I eventually got to a room where there's six different things that all take me a lot of time to kill and I can't just like stun lock them because, oh, no wonder those connections are so bad. They're from all over the goddamn place. It was not a good look. All of that was not... Oh, now I have to play this motherfucker. Really? You know what? I'm gonna try it. I mean, if that shit is any indication, we got some bullshit ahead of us, so let's try to fight fire with fire. If I can remember where these characters even are. Let's go for it. Has he been letting the timer run out? This guy is just the best human being in the world. There's a slot reserved in hell for you. You know, there are those kind of people out there in the world that's like, you just kind of hope hell is real to account for them? Oh, okay. He knew. He knew it was in his future. He knew what was prepared for his future. Good call. Damn, what is with all of, like, does nobody American still play this game? Is that what's going on? The entirety of the United States has given up on this dumbass game? This is not a good sign that, like, we're stuck here. Did the world broke? The world broke! Great! Great! We sat through that fucking dumbass bullshit to end on that. I've never actually had that happen before. I wonder what happened. Because obviously my internet is not down or anything. I'm very curious to know, like, exactly, specifically what just went down right there. But yay, so now we get to restart the whole process. And the entire point of the whole Dark Souls thing was that I had some shit to talk about, and now I don't. I still haven't gotten to the Bone Fist, though. I still haven't beaten Ava, I think is what it's called. Although I have the item now, but I kept going on and exploring, which was really dumb of me, actually, because there's a bunch of shit in the level that's frozen. So, like, a bunch of items, a bunch of paths, just a bunch of stuff. Ooh, a Felicia and a Jill? I'm glad that happened. I don't even care that you have Virgil on your team. You're using Felicia, and I'm interested. But yeah, there's a bunch of shit just barricaded behind an area event that needs to happen to unlock it. Ha! That cross up. This dude's hugging the corner and he still got crossed up. Gotta fucking love Wesker and Virgil. Those supers are just the most random thing in the game. What is this dude doing? But eventually, after exploring, like I said, I got to this room that there's just five things. Actually, I think there's six. Two of them I can kill pretty easily, but they're spellcasters and they don't move, so like I have to actually run into the room and try to fight them, which is just not an intelligent choice on my part in any way, shape, or form. Like, I'll get blown up by all the melee dudes that are in there if I try to do that. And I cannot handle it. I can't do it. Maybe later, but right now, I don't know. Maybe I need to try it with a different weapon? Why would you do that? This dude, is this dude a real Wesker? But he dropped it. No real Wesker would drop an online combo. Why? Like, Jill's useless now. Jill is useless now. Why would you have Jill as your anchor if you're gonna X-Factor as Wesker? Wow. I understand now. There is no why. We're online. People just doing stuff. See? Just doing stuff. Akuma can punish that easy. Has this dude just not played Akuma in 5 years and forgot the commands for everything? Like, what the fuck, dude? He's also playing Wolverine Akuma. Super jump dive kick, guaranteed to work. Nice, you're gonna get 5% damage. Huh. I wonder why those arrows didn't come down. I think the arrow... I don't think the arrows disappear if he gets hit completely. I mean, apparently they do. I would have to assume they do since they did just disappear. Man, I wish I had learned Jill. I really do. Like, now it's not, obviously, it's no longer worth trying to, like, learn this game. If you have not gotten into this game by now, it is absolutely not worth trying to get into anymore. For shizzle. But, so, I mean, you know, that's the thing. It's just really not worth learning anything new. Who should I use? I don't know. I'm very conflicted. I don't know who to use. You know what? Let's use Frank. I kind of want to use Frank. We'll see what we can do. obviously taking these 3 month breaks in between play time is definitely a brilliant idea. It's always gonna end well. Go for broke. Fight! Nope, no air grab for me. Get here. How you doing? Was not supposed to get a dash first. I should not have dashed into that. Like, it's Wesker. You don't dash under Wesker. There are just certain characters you don't fuck with. In that manner. I think I may actually live through this. Nope. Nope! Well, so much for that idea. I fucked up. Why am I pressing buttons when Wesker's falling? See, this is what. Bad habits. Bad habits is what not playing this game for 5 years gets you. My fault. My fault for pressing buttons. Like, he did the same exact setup twice in a row. I should have adjusted to that. Oh my god, that hitbox. Yo, Capcom hitboxes. What? That's cool. I'll take all of it. I deserve to get hit by that. Surely I would not have blocked a fucking jumping attack. My own fault. 100% my own fault. Like, regardless of what happened there, I didn't deserve to win for getting hit with Nova and Hawkeye like I did. That was absolutely dumb of me. What can you expect, though? You expect to just hop online after not playing for 7 years and just be able to blow people up? Yes. That's the kind of game Marvel is. Yes, absolutely. I should have. I had every opportunity to do so. I got that air grab and somehow ended up getting that dash, which obviously fucked everything up. I need to be doing that, because with Nova, you can fall faster after doing the air grab by hitting C on the way down. And in doing so, you fall faster, which gives you more time to confirm the throw, and it actually allows you to I think get more damage off of it, because you can do a crouching medium instead of a regular crouching B instead of just a normal 5B. Boy, yeah, this dude's gonna die. Zero Dante, fair and balanced. Zero's blockable, guys, did you know that? Zero incoming is completely reactable and blockable according to the Grandmaster Flux. Oh, had a good laugh about hearing that one. Had a wonderful laugh about hearing that one. He also believes Millie is fair. Had a grand laugh about that one, too. It's amazing. Like, there's two... Everybody. It's so amazing watching people try to downplay the characters they play. Like, oh no, it's completely player skill. It's not the character. What have you done outside of Marvel, Flux? Tell me. What have you done without Zero, bitch? Nothing. He ain't done nothing, says the dude sitting in a chair. He's done literally nothing ever. It's okay if you can't do critique. That's how it works, right? I should never have stopped going to tournaments. It's a shame. It's a shame the way life spun around. You know, there were a lot of things that kind of occurred around the same kind of sort of time-ish. And all of them were just kind of, you know, it just added up to be like, alright, it's not really worth going anymore. Ironically, it was largely thanks to the job. Like, at first I was considering, like, I really shouldn't be going to these things anymore because I'm starting to run out of money that I had saved up. And I don't want to dip into the emergency fund in order to go to tournaments. That would be a poor idea. And then I ended up getting a job. And now I have all the money I could want. I'm not a billionaire or nothing, just a couple million. But I wish. I would have better internet if I had a couple million dollars. I would not live in Sacramento if I had a couple million dollars. So anyway, moving on past that. But, you know, I had plenty of spending money, and now I could actually afford to go to tournaments. But now it's like, because I don't want to say the first tournament I went to after, because I don't know. I can't remember specifically what the first tournament was that I went to after I ended up getting a job. But that was around the time where I kind of stopped going because largely the organization for all the tournaments kind of fell apart. Venues kind of fell apart and people were kind of looking for new things. Oh, you know what it actually was? I'm entirely correct. I'm sorry. That happened later. That was another kind of addition. What actually ended up happening was that everybody started going to Game Center. And Game Center kind of killed it because, number one, the venue fee for just going to tournaments went up when they switched to Game Center, which is perfectly fine. Like, obviously, homie needs to make his money. I'm not complaining about that part. The big part that killed it was that the only effective way for me to get there, there were two main ways for me to get there. The first required me to go through toll booths, which cost me an extra $10, which at that point in time was just like, this is not worth it. It's already, like, basically, going to a tournament at that point in time cost me, without considering, you know, potential food, potential meals, whatever else happens, without considering that, it would cost me in total in gas, tolls, various other things, entrance fees, basically around $80 to $90 just to go to a local tournament that features, like, 15 people. I actually did the math, and if I won the tournament, if every single tournament I went to, I won, I still would not have come out even. And that's, again, without even factoring, you know, like, potentially going out for food, potentially buying drinks, whatever, you know, whatever extra kind of price stuff, what extra money spending might come up when you, you know, go out somewhere. So that was kind of just like, yeah, let's not do this, because I don't practice enough to be capable of getting first at everything anyway. And that was kind of when the NorCal scene was dying down in the first place anyway. But, so, that was kind of just, You know what? It was also, like, it's kind of coming back to me, all the reasonings for it. That was also when Extend was coming out. And we all know how I feel the same way about Continuum Shift Extend as I feel about CP Extend. It's just, it was not a good game. Balanced? Sure. Good? Fun? Absolutely not. So, I had stopped playing around then, too. And it was just, I kind of just stopped going to things. And it's unfortunate, too, because, like, I was building myself a pretty solid reputation, especially, obviously, mostly for commentary. But, you know, that was definitely a point where, like, I could have sacrificed money in order to continue building a reputation and potentially get somewhere in the tournament scene. What the fuck was that? And obviously, you know, I chose the way I chose. It's all hindsight's 2020 and whatnot. And now it's kind of the same exact thing. Like, NorCal has a very strong core community, but I don't think it's grown at all. Like, ever since I left, it's, as far as I'm aware, it's basically still, like, the same people, minus about, like, 5 or 10 other regulars. And those 5 or 10 other regulars, like, not to knock the current people that are there. There are some wonderful people that I enjoy spending time with that still go to those tournaments. I'm actually not sure if Veneath completely dropped the anime side of things for Marvel. I know for a while, like, he was definitely focusing very heavily on Marvel, but he still came to the, like, official tournaments. He just kind of stopped coming to gatherings and stuff like that. But, you know, Veneath, I enjoy spending time with him. Orion X Elite. That's a short list. That's a very short and sad list of people, isn't it? 2GB combo I enjoy spending time with. I'm trying to think of who else was, like, is, like, a regular there that I really know and I, like, regularly talk to. That's it. Like, all the other regulars, Dacidbro, Copper Dabbit, White Boy Willie, I don't think any of them, obviously Mystic D's long gone. Like, most of the regulars that I spent time with, like, outside of tournaments on top of, you know, enjoying their company in tournaments, they're basically gone. And so it's kind of just like all these people have drifted off and, you know, gone off their own separate ways, which is bound to happen. You know, you're kind of just, when you're in college, you're just kind of looking for something to waste the time that you have, like, while you're just trying to set up your life for the future. And then once the future has arrived, and now you want to get fucking started, you want to focus on it, you don't want to be spending erroneous time on, you know, fighting game stuff when you could be building up a very solid future. So, you know, I completely understand, I don't begrudge them for it, but that's a large part of why is, like, now I show up to those events, and it's just kind of like, there's nothing, like, here, the soul's kind of gone, if that makes any kind of sense. Plus, like, NorCal's notoriety is kind of gone as well. Like, I really don't, but the few times that I remember about the anime gatherings, I do try to check out the stream, and I don't think I've ever seen them break 100 viewers, which is bad. Like, I know they regularly used to get over 1,000 viewers at the old tournaments that, you know, like, I used to go to, and, you know, that had the really all the really solid players and the really entertaining players, and I guess those just don't exist anymore because they don't get views. Obviously, the BB vlog is gone, which was a very large part of NorCal's spirit. Shout outs to Rin Harasaki. Love that dude too, but he was gone long before everybody else was as well. Like, he went to focus on life too. He just got started faster than most of the other people. So yeah, it's just, you know, all these people that I went for, like, you know, the personalities, the enjoyment, the soul of the entire thing is kind of just gone, and it sucks. So that's kind of largely why, like, I've never really gotten back into it. I probably would have at the beginning of O'Neill if I had been smart enough to actually get into O'Neill when it first came out and when it actually had a community. But then, I mean, NorCal does still have a pretty strong offline community for O'Neill, probably the strongest offline community in the United States for that game. But I have tuned into some of that, and NorCal is Gordo Central. And obviously, I can't really talk about that given that I use Gordo myself, but, like, I would rather main. That was just completely beautiful in every sense of the word. That entire thing was just beautiful. This entire everything is amazing to watch. But I mean, obviously, you know, I switched to Nanase and tried to use Nanase a lot more than Gordo. I found Nanase more fun. Like, obviously Gordo was a hell of a lot easier to win with, but I thought Nanase was more fun. But in that decision would have been made a hell of a lot faster if I ever went to a NorCal gathering and was like, wow, I am number one of 12 Gordos in this room. Let me not use that character, because fuck mirror matches. They always suck. Why are you doing stuff? Well, now you just lost, actually. Shoutouts to this dude. Fucking around, got bopped. How could you not block? Like, what could he possibly have been doing that would cause him to not? Maybe he just doesn't want to play anymore. He gave it away. I don't know. I'm kind of thinking about it. I really don't think Hulk, Sentinel, Phoenix can work in this game. I don't think either one of those characters have the meter gaining ability to make Phoenix work. Because obviously in Marvel, vanilla Marvel, it was a lot easier to gain meter. But now you need characters like Magneto. Actually, really, you kind of just need TACs in general, don't really? Like, if you really have to consider it, pretty much everybody that uses Phoenix, if they win, it's because they got a TAC infinite and got the meter. Let's try to use the crutch. But now I don't know who to use as an anchor. Should we go super crutch? Super crutch! I say super crutch like I even moderately know how to use X-Factor Wesker. Never done it. Ooh, this is not a good look. That was a wrong assist. I fucked up! I actually don't really know where that jump came from. Can't believe that didn't hit. That was a mistake to hit a button on the way down. What? God damn, I cannot air grab. I had to focus so hard to win a fucking online match, and I still sucked. Good golly gee willikers. I can't air throw. I suck at air throws now. I used to be pretty decent at them, but now I just can't space them. I don't know if it's like character unfamiliar. I mean, I guess I got a fair amount of them with X23, but I don't fucking know how to pick those up. Actually, I don't think you can. I think you can pick them up if you're like right next to them. When you're like right above the ground, or kind of like similar to a little bit underneath normal jump, because then it doesn't kick them as far away. But other than that, like, I don't think it's really possible. So let me try. I want to try X23. I love this character so much, and I truly do wish I had actually. That's another character. I mean, there's a fair amount of characters in this game that I wish I had taken the time to learn, and that I never did. But I mean, beyond like a remedial level, I suppose. And X23 is definitely kind of at, very high on that list. Already, I get ready to brawl. Fight! Ooh. Yeah, that was a mistake. I autopiloted. An OTG assist is She-Hulk? Really? Why? She can self-OTG. Oops, I forgot. I forgot doing regular S in the air actually gives you the normal. Aww, I wasn't still in recovery. Now I'm just smashing buttons. I got blown the fuck up. That was a mistake. That's not gonna kill her. Oh wow, she actually recovers quite quickly from that. That was a mistake to hit a button. I should have just jumped. I thought I might still, like, the same scenario that I was already in.
Give me a break.
fine. I didn't get my. I wanted a launcher. I didn't get it. Oops, that's an overhead. I would have gotten shipped anyway. I should have just countered for shits and giggles. I made poor decisions all across the board there. It all started when I fucked up with X23. So anyway, hope you enjoyed that terrible showcase of gameplay from me. I mean, at least that player was good. That player was very decent. I have no complaints about the quality of that player, even though they use an OTG assist with She-Hulk, which still, that bothers me a little bit. Like, that should not have, no. You should never have to use an OTG assist to She-Hulk. So anyway, that's a marvel for you.